everybody, it's your girl Dani here again with GT Caribbean, and today we are sitting with a phenomenal woman, a great DJ. Let's introduce Trinidad and Tobago to DJ Mika. Hi Mika, how are you?
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm great.
And Mika, tell us about yourself, about your childhood. Where did Mika grow up? Where did you start?
Right, I'm coming from Poland originally. I live now 1 year in Trinidad. I'm originally from Poland. And with the year of three, I was moving with my family to Germany. So I was grown up in Germany, went to school there, university. I'm a studied media scientist and a scientist for communication. And I started to DJ during my studies, actually.
What got you into DJing? From media communications to DJ, what got you into DJing?
It was more the other way around. I was from the DJ to the media and communication, because I was listening to reggae and dancehall music in the south of Germany. It was always really nice. With 18, 19, we were always going to the parties. And then I was moving away and studying in the north of Germany. And there was not really something comparable, and I couldn't understand it, because in the south they celebrated the music, and Caribbean music in Europe is something not what you hear regularly on the radio, right? So it's kind of underground music, so it's great when you find the underground people. So I started those days with my boyfriend, yeah, to make music, and we started to create a party. And the first time I was DJing was in front of 630 people, yeah, that all came and wanted to see the result of the event, yeah.
First time DJing in front of 630 people. I can't even imagine that. That would blow my mind. What attracted you to Caribbean music and soca music?
I think because it is something absolutely different than what we have on our side. It's an absolute different lifestyle, what you have here, not like Jamaica or Trinidad or even the other Caribbean islands. And it's a different way of how people see things in life, and I really appreciate, this is my little cat, by the way, that's Betty. Betty. Ah. Yeah, she ruined my life right now, so, one second. Betty, come on.
Dude, sorry. The cat is ruling things, yo. I don't know. So yeah, you were telling us about what attracted you to Caribbean music.
I like the flow, I like the rhythm, I like the fast beat of the soca. I like the slackness. Right. Yeah. That's a part of the music, that's a way of expression. I like the rebel and the rasta character in the reggae, and I love Trinidad that I can just have everything here. I can have like a soca event with foam and colors and all that kind of stuff. But I can also have a very spiritual reggae night if I want to. Or I can have a real ghetto club, right? Like, it depends on what do I want on that night. And everything is just possible here because of the diversity of people and what people do. And I want to be a part of it, right?
So, you said you love the fact that you could have anything in Trinidad. Yes, we are very diverse. We need to appreciate that, people. We are very diverse. Is that what made you move to Trinidad? What inspired you to come to Trinidad?
The first time I was in Trinidad in 2015, and it was the first time I was ever in the Caribbean. It was like, wow, everything was real, and I got a chance to play on a radio station, 104.7, and it started a little hype, and everything was great. But at the same time, I got a little, a little disrespect, because there was a lot of DJs that looked at me like, oh, she can't be a DJ, this white girl, now what is that white girl, right? So it was often that I went on a spot and was supposed to play, or somebody organized it for me to have a little performance, and then it didn't happen. It just didn't happen because the people didn't trust that this white girl can rural things, right? And somehow it motivated me to come back. So a year later, I came back and took part in the International Soca DJ competition, and which was not really successful in the aftermath. It's not really a title, and until today, I don't know who I was. But I wanted to show that I'm back, and I'm not, you know, I could have just go and keep that disrespect and just say Trinidad is not nice, and I go to another island or something. But I decided to come back and show everybody what I can do. So that's why I came. And during the time I'm here, I just realized that there's a lot of stuff I can just improve with my knowledge, right? So I'm trying to give my knowledge to the people here, you know, make life a little bit easier or help to make people to go on the next level, like artist-wise, producer-wise, or even DJ-wise, right? So I'm just here and working on some stuff.
So we're still here with DJ Mika, you know, finding out about her experiences, her likes, why she's in Trinidad, what motivates her to stay in Trinidad. And, you know, Mika, a little while ago, you were talking about the disrespect that you experienced the first time you were here from some of your male counterparts. Let's talk about that, because we all know soca industry, the DJ game, sorry to say, but it's a boys' club and not much girls get to break through. So talk to me about that. How was your experience in terms of trying to break into this?
Well, what I experienced a lot is people are very surprised that the girl can do it, right? That the girl is able to press buttons, right? Actually, it's not really hard to DJ. It's more about getting your all power together and put it into your passion and maybe invest a little bit money, you know, for a little equipment. And then you will see, like, one will bring the next, and you can be successful in Trinidad as a woman, right? But you need to want it, and you need to have your own style, right? Like the same thing I would advise to guys too, right? I see a lot of DJs that don't really have, like, a real face, if you understand what I mean. Like, everybody is like the same, or everybody is looking for the same style, the same selection and stuff. And I'm more like somebody, wow, wanna come and surprise with a little remix or a little acoustic version or something special like that. Yeah, so that's more my thing, right? And of course, there's a lot of music out there coming from Europe, coming from Norway, Sweden, Finland, but it even can come from Africa somewhere. And that music, you don't know here yet, but I would like to be the one introducing it, right?
What was your first breakthrough experience in Trinidad in terms of, okay, so you went through the disrespect, you went through, you know, the hard times of trying to break onto the scene. What was your first successful gig, I would say, in Trinidad? When did you feel, yeah, okay, I'm here?
Whoa. In which year now? This year or?
The first one. Anyone. You pick.
Well, that was actually on 104.7, that video footage. Like, I have it also. I can show you a little piece if you want, right? There's a video, like an interview with Robert Amar also. Right? Say how important it is. And yeah, sadly, we never came together to work on that radio station, but for now, I'm working on a new project. It's called Caribbean Music Worldwide. It's going to be an international online platform for Caribbean music, reggae worldwide, soca worldwide, dancehall worldwide. And what I want to do is inform people about, okay, where now those are, like, where do those artists come from? And so this person is coming from St. Vincent, but he's living in New York. So what's his background? What's his stories? You know, like, what I see a lot with soca music is that the artists often don't really have a face. When you look at it on a global scale, you see people enjoying the music a lot, right? Singing the songs, but if they would meet the artist now on the street, it's not the Beyoncé or Rihanna effect that you would have, right? So I want to bring at least the face a little bit back. And yeah.
So I think that's a huge mission, and I applaud you for taking on that mission. So let's bring it back now to what we are known for in Trinidad, our carnival. Have you experienced our carnival since you've been here all these years?
Of course, to the max. Everybody that saw me on the road knows what I'm talking about. So
yeah. So you experienced carnival, you played mass. What did you do? Talk to me about your carnival experience.
In the first year, I truly was on the road, all by myself, like with nobody else. And I was writing on my arm, I'm a DJ. And I was going from truck to truck and tried it. I tried it. It was my biggest dream to play music on the carnival. The year later, I made it on the Generation Lion Juve truck. And that was cool, but it's not the carnival. But the carnival is for me always a very, like, it is like a bad story, because my biggest dream is to DJ in a carnival costume and look extremely nice, and the costume is like like extra made for me, you know, because you can't have the big headpiece when you have the headphones, and I was dreaming of it. And last year I was so close. Everything was managed with Legacy and everybody was happy that I'm coming. And I put this costume on the drinks truck of the Juve band, and the drinks truck drives away during when I was playing music. So it just disappeared, and I was picking up the stuff on Ash Wednesday somewhere in Lavantil in a box. So that's the story. Yeah. So my carnival story. But I love how the people come together and enjoy themselves. I wish myself a little bit more traditional aspects for the future. So that's what I'm working on personally for my upcoming carnival experience.
Okay, so we're back again. Still sitting here with DJ Mika and her kitty cat. Cute kitty. So Mika, tell us about what does the future hold? What do you have planned for 2018?
Oh, there's a lot of great things in plan. The first thing actually starts already in December. It's an event series, which will be always on the first Saturday of the month in Sawan at the Mango Room. It's a spot that nobody knows yet really too much, but it's an amazing location with a nice backyard with mango trees. And I'm going to try to get the best out of this spot. So we're going to start with a glow-in-the-dark event, Neon Time to Shine Glow Fit. That's the name of it. So we're going to have like decoration and nice music, great DJs, of course. I have a lot of DJ friends and can't wait to play. In January, we're going to continue with that event series at the same spot with Jumanji Safari Fit. So everything will be kind of junglish. And you're going to dress up in animal print. And the neon, I want you to come in neon clothes or in white clothes, right? And for the third one, I have something very special because it's going to be my 10 years DJ Jubilee and a charity event for the children of Belmont, which are going to celebrate their Carnival Sunday with the kids on the road and on a Juve truck. So we're going to make a nice little Juve truck for the kids, and then we're going to morph the truck for the adults in the evening, and the big special thing is it's going to glow too. So be prepared for that. I'm looking forward. The kids will be a part of it. Everybody will do decoration. Everybody will represent Belmont in a proper way. It's all about also to show like that areas that have a certain image can still show that there's great people out there. So let's see how this gonna be, but I'm looking very forward. And of course, I'm hoping to find a mass band where I can play in a costume, right?
Mass bands, all you hearing that, right? Paging all band leaders. DJ Mika wants to play in a costume, so let's make that happen. Mika, how can we contact you via social media for bookings, or if somebody wants to give you a costume, how do we contact you?
All right, the easiest thing, you just Google DJ Mika, M-I-K-A Trinidad. You also can log on www.mikaragua.com or check Mikaragua on IG or on Facebook. You will get through, I think. There's a lot of footage out there from all the years. Like, I was playing a lot and all over Europe, right? So, yeah, enjoy my little history. I hope you like it. There's a lot of music to download as well for your car or, you know, for your next backyard party. You never know.
All right, so that has been your girl Dani sitting here with DJ Mika for GT Caribbean. You know, girls can do it too. Later, people. Bye.